Crowdfunding for startup, the situation for caring finance. The global financial crisis itself has stimulated the emergence of ethically sound finance practices from within the sector. So caring finance is built around more personal relationships, responsibility and risk reduction. So crowdfunding is a part of caring finance which has been emerged after the global financial crisis, which was happened in 2018. So crowdfunding means it is a process of accumulating money from a large number of people or organizations. So here is the crowd refers to people or organizations that offer the money. In this way, you can get money through both small individual donations and organizational investments. So crowdfunding is a collective effort by people who network and contribute collectively for a cause or a business idea. So if you have a business idea, you can approach the crowdfunding for funding. So there are websites available for crowdfunding and you can upload your idea. And once the idea is feasible, then the crowdfunding will initiate the proceedings of funding arrangements for your venture. So as Securities Exchange Board of India has been defined crowdfunding as a crowdsourced funding is a means of raising money for a creative project. It will be music, film, book publication, etc. A benevolent or a public interest cause or a business venture through small financial contributions from persons who may number in the hundreds or thousands. So SEBI clearly defined a crowdfunding, but all forms of crowdfunding is in different forms, but all forms of crowdfunding is not legalized by Securities Exchange Board of India and RBI. So we can understand in the coming slides about the legally valid crowdfunding schemes in India. So those contributions are sold through the online crowdfunding platform, while the offer may also be promoted through social media. So it is a definition given by Securities Exchange Board of India 2014. So RBI also defined crowdfunding as crowdfunding generally refers to a method of funding a project or a venture through small amounts of money raised from a large number of people, typically through a portal acting as an intermediary. Here is the importance of a portal or a website. This website acts as a catalyst or a mediator for collecting funds from the people. So whoever have an idea can upload the project, and the crowdfunding platform will check and review the idea. And after that review, the idea is feasible, then the crowdfunding enable funding requirements or funding schemes. So types of crowdfunding. So as I said, say crowdfunding are different types. First one is securities based crowdfunding. Securities based crowdfunding comes with opportunities for people to invest in startups. So this type of campaign promises investors with stock or a future shares of the company, or gives you any security policy in exchange for the investment. So the securities based crowdfunding is also termed as equity based crowdfunding. So the crowdfunding platform gives a fund, and against that the company need to give the shares of equal amount. And once the startup or a venture which was started after funding from this equity crowdfunding, and they will sell the shares and make profit. So equity based crowdfunding, this type of funding involves offering equity shares to the investors in return for their investment. So thus people who invest in the startup become its shareholders. It is essential for the investors to weigh their risk and return preferences. So how to get a profit after investment? You know, the crowdfunding, equity based crowdfunding, the funding needs equity division or equity shall be given to the funders. Their reward is equity. Their reward will arise after the company is flourished. And once the company is flourished or the company started earning profit, the funders will sell the shares of that company to other parties, and they can make profits. In India, such funding of the startups through equity shares have to comply with the private placement guidelines as dealt with in the Companies Act 2013. So this crowdfunding in India means equity crowdfunding in India especially follows the same guidelines given by Companies Act 2013 for private placement guidelines. So the company, the crowdfunding platform collect funds through the equity crowdfunding. They have to follow the same guidelines of the private placement as dealt by the Companies Act 2013. So there is another crowdfunding platform, that is peer-to-peer crowdfunding. So it enables an individual to get a loan from another specific individual without third party like banks. Here the peer-to-peer process is working out, and here there is an absence of a bank. So another one is debt-based crowdfunding. The money lent by the investors carries a fixed rate of interest, and the principal amount is repaid to them after a given number of years. This is exactly the debt-based crowdfunding. Some online platforms facilitate lending and borrowing of loans between individuals, while others facilitate pooling of funds for onward lending to the small and medium-sized enterprises. So apart from the equity-based crowdfunding, we are learning this peer-to-peer lending. Here individual to get loan from another specific individual without third party, and debt, it's exactly money lent by the investors carries a fixed rate of interest, same thing like bonds. So another one is donation-based crowdfunding. Here the people lend money for charitable, social and humanitarian purposes without expecting anything in return. So people come forward to contribute money when they perceive a worthwhile cause which will have a positive impact on the society. So this is something like charity crowdfunding. So the people may come forward to contribute money for constructing a temple or old age home etc. for the donation prize crowdfunding. So there are examples such as Keto is one of the example of donation based crowdfunding. They have helped in raising funds to support the spokespersons from low income groups and tribal communities compete in national and international events. So there is a crowdfunding campaign we have to meet the startups. Has to prepare action plan. Action plan consists of plan your budget, appealing proposal, and you know there is a story will do the matter. The story is to be projected and reflected to the funders. So they have to appreciate the effort of the startups or appreciate the story developed by the startup, and the story has to be communicated properly, and the startup idea should have some social signals. That social signals will be a positive impact on the funders to fund it. And also video of the action plan, the video should be a better one. And websites, you know, many websites, many platforms. For one of the platform is Kickstarter. Kickstarter is one of the first crowdfunding sites in India. The platform is most known for the creative projects. Film, book, research and innovation are some of the kinds of campaigns that are often seen on this platform. So go to the website of Kickstarter and upload the project. Here I can show the website of Kickstarter, and you know the website, you can give the idea. This is the website of Kickstarter, and describe what you will be creating, and don't worry, you can edit this later too. So you can just type your idea and submit. And there is another platform, Wishbury. So here also we can create ideas about these art, comics, publishing, theater, music, This Vishwar is specialized in this area. So if anybody has a startup idea regarding these comics, publishing, theater, music, they can upload the project. And Indiegogo is more than crowdfunding size. It's funding and marketable platform. Here, raising funds is the first step. Following a successful crowdfunding campaign, campaigners can take their idea to the next level to continue raising funds. So the Indiegogo focus area is product innovation, bring innovative ideas to life. The purpose of mission to be launched pad for entrepreneurial ideas. So another one is Fundable. It's another platform of crowdfunding. Here also you can upload the business ideas. So Keto is another one. It's Keto, you know, already discussed. Keto is popular for the charity based crowdfunding, and it is creative, entrepreneurial, NGO, personal causes, education. The mission to bring social change, raise awareness and raise funds. So this is the process of the crowdfunding. You know, the first process, identification of the project caused by the initiator. Next one is selection of the crowdfunding platform. So if you have a startup, you are planning a startup, this is a process you can repeat for getting the funds. First one, the identification of the project caused by the initiator. Next step is selection of crowdfunding platform. So the crowdfunding platform we discussed, Kickstarter or Indiegogo or Keto, different platforms. You can approach a platform. The platform should be in tune with your business idea, and the introduction of a project. You can introduce the project, storytelling. The story should be understandable and should be able to connection with the listeners. Then updating the progress of the project. Then receiving contribution made by the crowd through crowdfunding platform, and start the project, earn returns and reward the crowd through crowdfunding platform. So there is a platform, the presence of the platform, you can give the reward to the funders after your success. So legal support, you know, I discussed the legal support only right now for equity based crowdfunding in India. Other crowdfunding like peer-to-peer crowdfunding, debt-based crowdfunding and charity-based crowdfunding is not legalized. Means somebody lost funds or somebody have cheated up through this crowdfunding, it is no law to prohibit or no law is available to control the frauders. So be careful while doing these crowdfunding platforms. You know, the only equity based crowdfunding is legally permitted right now, but still the others are also working. You know, P2P, peer-to-peer lending falls under the jurisdiction of the RBI. So that we can say that P2P lending and equity-based crowdfunding are the authorized and legalized crowdfunding platforms. Others, you have to be taken care of while investing through the others crowdfunding, usually, you know, the charity-based crowdfunding or debt-based crowdfunding, etc. So, others are not legalized yet. So always you can prefer the equity based crowdfunding and P2P lending, which is been regulated by the RBI and SEBI. Okay, thank you.